As you know, fentanyl is a huge problem right now. Its use in illicit drug markets, either by itself or as a substitute in other drugs, is causing tens of thousands of overdoses each year. This is due to the lethal dose of fentanyl being so low, with the average person only needing to ingest around 2 milligrams of fentanyl to be at risk of an overdose. Until recently, fentanyl and its analogues made up the majority of synthetic opioids on the market. However, a new class of compounds has now emerged, one that is up to 10 times stronger than fentanyl. After World War II, research began on new analgesics that were distinct from morphine and its derivatives. The goal was to remove the side effects associated with this class of molecules, such as respiratory depression and constipation, as well as addressing the tolerance and addictive properties of morphine-based analgesics. In the 1950s, the Swiss pharmaceutical company Ceba discovered a class of compounds with similar effects to morphine, but with a vastly different chemical structure from both morphine and fentanyl, which was discovered around a similar time. This class of compounds came to be known as nitazenes. The most active compound in this class, etonitazene, was observed to be 1,000 times more potent in treating pain than morphine. Nitazenes bind to the same target as morphine and fentanyl, the mu opioid receptor, but with an affinity that is 10 times larger than that of fentanyl. The original synthesis for these molecules involved starting with a phenylene diamine, which underwent a condensation with an amino ether, which could be made from the corresponding nitrile compound. An amino group attacks the amino ether in an addition elimination reaction, where the imine is reformed and the ethoxy group is displaced. The second amino group then attacks the imine, with a lone pair on one of the nitrogen atoms kicking out ammonia. The benzimidazole could then be alkylated with diethyl aminoethyl chloride, resulting in two regioisomers that had to be separated due to the two tautomeric forms of the benzimidazole. An improved synthesis involves an SNAR reaction on a dinitrophenol compound with the corresponding ethylene diamine. Regioselective reduction of the adjacent nitro group was carried out using ammonium sulfide. EEDQ is used as a coupling reagent to form the amide bond by converting the carboxylic acid to a mixed anhydride group, activating it for attack from the amino group. This molecule can then cyclize in an analogous way as we have seen before, but this time leading only to the desired regioisomer of the product. This method allowed for the rapid expansion of derivatives containing substituted phenyl groups from their carboxylic acid building blocks. The activity of a range of nitazene compounds were described in publications by the Ceba group. These studies involved injecting the compounds into mice and measuring their ability to treat pain by observing the delay in reaction time to a heat source. The study showed that the nitro group is key for the high pain-treating ability, with the desnitro compound being 14 times less active. Another important group is at the fourth position of the benzyl ring, with alkoxy substituents being the most active, followed by alkyl thiol groups, halogens, and hydrogen. The structure-activity relationship of the alkoxy group showed that the ethoxy group was the most potent, followed by isopropoxy, propoxy, and then the methoxy group. Interestingly, the phenyl derivative was much less potent, suggesting that these compounds bind differently than morphine-based compounds, which require a group capable of acting as a hydrogen bond donor to produce activity. Some of these analogues, such as etonitazene, clonitazene, and metonitazene, were investigated in clinical trials in humans. These trials yielded mixed results, and the compounds were never further developed by Ceba, presumably due to their addictive properties and ability to depress the respiratory system, a common side effect of all opioids. As a result, this class of compounds was forgotten and remained relatively unknown outside of academic use for research on mu opioid receptor pharmacology. In 1975, the chemist Alexander Shulgin, a legend in the psychoactive drug community, warned that nitazenes had the potential for abuse and use as heroin substitutes. In around 2018, fentanyl and its analogues started to become more regulated and controlled, making them harder to make or import. This led clandestine chemists to look back through old journals and articles were compounds that could be used as opioid substitutes. These compounds needed to be potent, easy to make, and have less regulations around themselves than their precursors. And with this, the nitazine class of analgesics were found. In 2019, nitazine started being found in various samples across Europe and North America. However, it was not one of the previously mentioned etonitazine or clonitazine, as these had already been placed in Schedule 1 under the Controlled Substances Act in 1961. The compound found in the samples was isotonitazine, the second most potent compound in the series behind etonitazine. It had been studied by CBER, but strangely had not been controlled like the other two. The main concern about nitazines is their contamination in various illicit substances, where users might not realize they are ingesting these compounds and thus will not be aware of their potential to cause respiratory depression. Nitazines generate other concerns when compared to fentanyl due to their ease of synthesis, potency, and the unclear legal status of their derivatives. While test strips for nitazines are available, it is unlikely people will use them if they are not aware of what nitazines are. There are also concerns about how nitazines are metabolized in the body. While no metabolite identification studies have been published for etonitazine or clonitazine, a recent study identified metabolites of isotonitazine from blood and urine samples. The primary metabolite was the N-desethyl compound, produced when isotonitazine is metabolized by a cytochrome P450 enzyme in an oxidative dealkylation reaction, a common phase 1 metabolism reaction which makes the compound more polar and easier for the body to excrete. The problem is, this metabolite is even more potent than isotonitazine itself, at least in the in vitro assays commonly used to measure opioid receptor activity. In addition to this, studies on mice show that this metabolite is responsible for a longer-lasting respiratory depression when compared to fentanyl, which may further increase the risk of overdose. Fortunately, like with other opioids, naloxone appears to be effective at reversing the effects and preventing a potential overdose. This compound works by acting as an opioid receptor antagonist and displacing the compound responsible for the overdose from the opioid receptor. Nitazine overdoses, compared to morphine and fentanyl, are likely to require higher and more frequent doses due to the higher affinity for the mu opioid receptor. Thank you for watching this video. If you want to help support the channel, giving this video a like is the easiest way you can help. Links to papers and references used will be in the description, and if you have any questions or discussion points, please leave them below in the comments.